because Jim Henson loved this area, lived here, a lot of his work was done here, and we're going to find some of the places that were associated with him. I was one of the puppeteers on the Muppet Show. My name's Louise Gold.
I love this place already! I've spent all my life savings to make this trip!
Where can you see
them? Over there! Quick! Run! Yay! It's a Miss Piggy, and on the back it's got an H. Up here. Sid!
Is that you?
Now this was where Jim first lived when he came to London. Jim and all the puppeteers absolutely loved it here. They thought it was beautiful. Jim loved the heath, he loved the area. And it was very special to him, and he loved working in London. Not everyone knows that all the Muppet shows were filmed at Elstree Studios. And the Americans all came over here en masse, and I was the only English puppeteer. So we've got another one. Are you going to hold them? So we've got an A. Put down on your list.
It's an A corresponding to Big Bird.
Oh, your very good friend, Big Bird.
Yeah. I tell you what, they're in a CDI. No one wants a puppet in LA.
I know.
Well, we've got another creature down here.
Rosie, come out so everyone can see you!
Now, this was offices, and the films were made out at Elstree Film Studios. But this was always where Jim came back to his home and where he loved it. So he loved having the offices here and the building, which we will see later in Downshire Hill, where a lot of Dark Crystal stuff was made.
How did you actually get to be Jim Henson's puppeteer?
Well, I started off as an actress, and part of the reason I got the job, the audition, was because I was tall. And the Muppet Show sets, in Sesame Street, everything is filmed like this, and it's very uncomfortable and bad for your back. But with Muppet Show, they got a bit more money, so the sets were all built up so that the puppeteers could stand up and work above their heads. And Jim Henson and Frank Oz were both over 6 foot tall, so they were built for them. So I, part of my skills was just being tall. I like to think a few other skills. So I went in to a room in Elstree, and there was Jim Henson sitting there with Kermit on his hand. Hey, you know, what do you do? And I got to sing with him, and they were looking for someone who could do voices, so they took someone who had an ability. And partly I got on with them all, and it was partly about the affection between the group, and trained me. So I got trained by Jim Henson. I started off doing little things and worked up. This was Jim's house after Frogmore Gardens. He bought this house in, I think, just after the Muppet Show finished. So many of my memories are doing the Muppet Show and just everyone laughing and having joy in it. And Jim's house was a place of joy. He decorated it. It was a bit of a fantasy, wacky, drapes everywhere, puppet stuff from the movies and things. Well, talk about, you know, having your work next door to where you live. So this was, I quote, purchased by the Henson organization to house Dark Crystal production. He did the boy puppet, and he was getting interested in animatronics. And the little boy had all kinds of mechanisms in its head. It was pretty unworkable. But Jim, because of who he was, would never say that. He tried to make it work. And Frank Oz, I remember being in there, Frank Oz came to look at his puppet. And Jim had been, you know, struggling away and trying this heavy, heavy puppet and trying to make it work. Frank came in, looked at his puppet and said, I can't work with that, change it. Because it was too heavy, it was too unworkable. And when we were doing the Muppet Show, the writers gave Jim, it was like light-up fruit machine that played the Muppet Show theme and lit up and said, simple is good. Brilliant. What have you got? We've got Gonzo the Great, and it's a Y. A Y.
Give him a break, Joey. We're all in this together.
Now this bench, Jim actually had this bench put here first of all for Don Saline, who was one of the great builders and worked with the Muppets. Jocelyn Stevenson, who was one of the writers with Muppets, told me a story that when they were trying to work out Fraggle Rock and get all the names of the characters, and they were coming up with all the names and the Fraggles and the Gorgs, but they hadn't got a name for the little creatures, if you know. So they went on a walk, all of them, just to clear the air and think of some ideas. And Jocelyn said she and Jim sat on this bench, and at the same moment, they both said, doozers. And they like to think that was Don Saline and his gift to them. And then when Jim died, it became Jim's bench as well.
I love all the Muppet shows and I love puppets and I thought it was amazing.
I thought it was fantastic. It was a surprise gift for my girlfriend, and she knows that I'm a huge Jim Henson fan, and I don't know, this has been something I've wanted to do for a long time, to see like his connection to London, and I don't know, it means a lot to me, so it's been a really wonderful day.